want to shoot this video to two groups in particular, right? The first group I want to post this video for is to the fans of South Carolina, right? South Carolina Gamecocks. And to the second group I want to address in this video are the Alabama fans, right? And to the fans of South Carolina, I want to first of all start off by saying, I'm sorry. I watched that game. I went back and watched it again, you know, just to make sure I wasn't tripping and my eyes wasn't tripping. And I wanted to say to you, your eyes are not tripping and you're not hallucinating and you're not being a homer. There were some calls that went against you that were absolutely devastating, you know. And you know, and I'm going to be honest with you, though. As I sit there and watch the game, I knew deep down at some point the SEC officiating crew was going to kick in and wrap LSU fans in this warm blanket of SEC protective custody. Yeah, it's the SEC protective custody blanket. This is the same blanket that Alabama fans have been wrapped in for so long. It's nice and it's cozy. Oh, it's nice, cozy, and warm. You know, it gives you this sense of invulnerability, you know, like you can really conquer the world. It's very, very comforting, you know, nice and snug in it, knowing that there isn't anything that's going to happen to you during the course of this game that's going to cause you to lose the game. And to the Alabama fans who have enjoyed this blanket for so long, I say, shame on you, big heads, bucket heads, shame on you, your ugly, ugly uniforms and your ugly schools, shame on you, because I was wrapped in that blanket this week. It's itchy, it's scratchy, it gives you the hives, you know, it feels like poison ivy. It wasn't like somebody done wrapped me in a Brillo pad. I did not like the feeling, the invincibility that came from this, knowing that the officiating crew was going to bail us out. And this is what you're hearing me say right now. You're not going to hear from anybody south of Shreveport, from Shreveport all the way down to Lafayette, all the way to the right, yeah, over to Lake Charles, to the left, all the way over to New Orleans. No one is going to admit that we as LSU fans experience something that Alabama has always enjoyed. That thing I used to call Bama privilege. Guys, I watched it. I watched LSU make some of the bonehead mistakes. You know, I watched one of the most poorly coached LSU teams I have ever seen get bailed out time and time again. And I'm sitting here saying, hush your mouth, TJ. Hush your damn mouth. Don't you say nothing about it. This is just the way football goes. This is the lawlessness of football. You hush your mouth and enjoy being the favorite. Enjoy what that means to be the favorite. But I'm not gonna hush my mouth. I'm gonna speak out against it and say, shame on you, SEC. Shame on you, SEC commissioner, for what you allowed to happen to those fans at South Carolina, for what you allowed to happen to that team that deserved to win, right? If not for those devastating calls that, you know, one of the calls was purely a phantom call completely. I'm not going to point that one out either. I'm going to just let that hang out, but the South Carolina fans know the one I'm talking about. Completely phantom. Devastating. So when people say that we were bailed out by the refs, we were bailed out by the refs. And this is what Brian Kelly football is. It's undisciplined, right? It's soft. It's confusion. This is the identity of a Brian Kelly football team. And it's a greater indictment, not as much on the SEC as it is at the athletic director of LSU. Because he's going to go down with the ship with this one. Just because he got a little national championship on the basketball side, he's going to go down with the ship. And this is his guy. This is his hand-picked guy. And what it's doing is it's destroying the legacy of LSU. LSU is going to become, under Brian Kelly, it's going to drift to the bottom tier of the SEC because we brought a bottom tier coach down here to coach it, and the team takes on the likeliness of the coach. And that's why we now need help from officiating crews. We never had no help. We won a national championship in 2019 under Coach Orgeron with no help. None. With all of the calls going against us. But now, we need something called a bailout. A stimulus check that comes in the form of a yellow flag that helps us get out of undisciplined football free. We get to commit all of these undisciplined mistakes, and here they come bailing us out. And so to the Alabama fans, for all of the years y'all enjoyed this and not a single one of y'all, all y'all got cell phones. All y'all. And not one of y'all posted a video to say it was wrong. I'm going to say it. What I watch happen to those fans at South Carolina and to that football team and to that boy Kennard on that defensive line, who I think is one of the greatest defensive linemen I've seen in a very long time. Please accept my apology. Because y'all did everything to win that game. But the SEC and their vested interest in having SEC schools dominate the college football poll would not allow it to happen. And that's when college football ceased to become college football and it becomes the Junkyard Dog and Hacksaw Duggan and WWE. It becomes scripted athletic events. And that's where we're headed at. I'm sorry, South Carolina, and shame on you Bama fans for not saying something sooner.